European Union foreign ministers are gathered in Brussels. The group threw support behind plans for a military freeze in Syria. They hope to restore basic infrastructure and governments to the city of Aleppo. The ongoing Ukraine crisis was also high on the agenda. CCTV's Jack Barton has this report from Brussels.
The embattled Syrian city of Aleppo. Those who remain survive without reliable electricity, water, or an effective administration. On Monday, the EU's foreign policy chief announced a fund and a plan to help change all that.
If and when we manage to have a freeze of hostilities in Aleppo, the European Union has to be ready to come in with a major humanitarian support to make the life of the people in Aleppo, if the freeze come, dramatically better than it has been so far.
The freeze is a United Nations plan to open up humanitarian corridors in Syria that is backed by the EU. But Syrian opposition groups have rejected the freeze, saying it plays into the hands of the Assad government, a concern shared by some EU member states.
We also think, frankly speaking, that we have to step up the support, the humanitarian support, the non-lethal support for the Free Syrian Army and the moderate opposition in Aleppo.
The chaos in Libya was also on the agenda, along with Ukraine, where fighting continues.
And frankly speaking, ceasefire also not working.
European foreign ministers discussed a proposal to ban EU firms from doing business with Crimea, which was absorbed by Russia earlier this year. The potential ban would exclude exports on equipment used for oil and gas exploration. The bloc's foreign policy chief, Federica Mogherini, will head to Ukraine on Tuesday, where she will meet with President Petro Poroshenko to discuss his country's political and economic reforms, as well as the security situation near the Russian border. Jack Barton, CCTV, Brussels.